Assalamu alaikum students, I am Mrs. Mazahira here. Today we are going to learn about two-nation theory. Two-nation theory is basically the basis of creation of Pakistan. The entire movement of freedom revolve around this theory, which was introduced by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. According to this theory, or the theory means the cultural, political, religious, economic and social similarities between the two major communities, Hindus and Muslims, who were living in the subcontinent. This theory means that there were two nations in the subcontinent, the Hindus and the Muslims, the subcontinent consists of two different communities having their own philosophy of life, own thinking of life and their own identities. This theory gave rise to two distinct political ideologies that was responsible for the partition of India into two independent states. Father of theory was Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, who played a vital role in improving the status of the Muslim community in the subcontinent. He worked tirelessly to restore relations with the British, particularly after the War of Independence, when many British were of the opinion that the Muslims were disloyal and untrustworthy. His writings, his tireless work and the example he set were to convince the British to see the Muslims in a new light. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan played a major part in the bringing about a Muslim revival, largely through the work of the Aligarh movement. Muslims came to value education as a mean of self-improvement and of obtaining better employment. From this came greater the feeling of self-worth. Linked to the Muslim revival was a great political awareness, as Hindus sought to take advantage of the poor relations between the Muslims and the British. Sir Syed emphasized the threat to the Muslims and developed his two-nation theory. Once Muslims came to accept this wisdom of this theory, it was only a small step to call for partition. For this reason, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan can rightly be called the father of the Pakistan movement. There are some major reasons or some major factors because of which two-nation theory promoted. Now we are going to learn about the factors which are going to promote two-nation theory. These are religious differences, cultural differences, social differences, political differences, language, and economical differences. So let's see the first, religious differences. Islam preaches Tawheed, oneness of Allah, and believes that Allah is the creator of the universe. Muslims are the believers of Allah, the Holy Prophet, the Messenger of Allah. Muslims firmly believe on the Holy Quran and the life hereafter. In the other mean, Hindus believe in many gods. They have thousands of gods. Prophets are people who see God. They teach about God and they have characteristics of God. Their writings are called Vedas. Then the cultural differences. Muslims followed the Islamic culture. Muslims buried their dead bodies. Muslims slaughtered the cow and they abhorred the tradition of Sati. In Islam, every human beings are equal. There is no caste system in Islamic society. While in the other mean, Hindus inherited a self-built culture. They burned their dead bodies and considered the mother cow as a scared animal. They performed sati and worshipped and exist a caste system in their religious manner. Then we have economical differences. Hindus provided opportunities to progress in the subcontinent when there was a rule of British, while Muslims were thrown outside the government and they didn't have any government job at that time because they have less education than the Hindus. Then social differences. The two communities of the subcontinent differ in their social lives, the clothes, the food, the household utensils, the construction homes, the word of greeting, the gestures, and everything about them was different and immediately represented to their distinctive origin. The moral values, ethics, and norms of both the communities are totally different. Political differences. The political differences between the Hindus and Muslims have played an important role in the evolution of two-nation theory. Firstly, we have Hindi-Urdu controversy. Hindi-Urdu controversy. In 1867, Hindus demanded the Urdu should be written in Hindi script instead of Urdu script. This created another gap between Hindus and Muslims. Then the Hindi-Urdu controversy began in the year 1867 when Hindus demonstrated against Urdu and demanded its replacement with Hindi as an official language. Some prominent Hindu leaders organized an agitation against the use of Urdu as official language and demanded that Hindi written should be introduced in the offices and courts as official language. Sir Syed Ahmed Khan was extremely disappointed to see the Hindus behaving like this. He was now convinced that Hindus would never be friendly with the Muslims. Then Congress attitude. The Indian National Congress came into existence in 1885 on the initiative of a retired British civil servant, Alan Octavian Hume. Indian National Congress, which gradually grew to be the most powerful political organization in India, was originally intended to provide a forum of the Indian politician to meet early and point out to the government in what respect the administration was faulty and how it could be improved. It had claimed at the time of its inception that it would strive for the safeguard of the interest of all communities in India, irrespective of their religion or political tendencies. For some time in the beginning, Congress did adhere to its promise and displayed a posture of a national organization, but with the time it turned into a pure Hindu body working for the safeguard of the interest of Hindus only. Then partition of Bengal and Congress attitude. In 1905, the partition of Bengal ensured a number of political benefits for the Muslims, but the Hindus launched an agitation against the partition and partition was annulled in 1911. Now there is a task to do. You have to write down this SLO and explain it in your copies. Trace the origin and evolution of two-nation theory with the reference to socio-economic and political conditions of Indian Muslims of the subcontinent from 1857 onwards.